calibration of Lite or NanoVNA. Welcome back to TakeApart. Today I will test this 433 MHz antenna that I used with my HackRF and flipperzero. If you want genuine Nano or LiteVNA, head to eleshop.eu and use coupon code TakeApart5 at checkout to get 5% discount, or use first link in description. But first, go menu, stimulus, then start and enter start frequency. I'll do 420 M as megahertz, and also enter stop frequency. I'll do 455 MHz. Now VNA looks only in that range, from 420 to 455 MHz. As you see, the missing calibration. We'll do it with these little guys. Hit menu, go back and hit calibrate, and again calibrate. Now it's time for SMA plug that mimics open circuit. It is this guy. Inside is missing core pin, so screw it on and hit open. Wait couple of seconds and letter O appears here, along with check mark here. Now change plug to short. This one has core pin that is shorted to shield or ground. Screw it on and hit short. Wait a bit and letter S appears. Now we have done 2 out of 3. Last is load. Load SMA plug looks like a regular connector, as it has 50 ohm resistor inside. Screw it on, hit load, and final check mark and letter L. Now hit done. I will override my existing calibration. This will save it for future, so I wouldn't have to calibrate in that frequency range. Alright, let's see how this antenna performs. Here it is. Oh, but I'll have to change marker and search for minimum. As SWR is lower, the better. This antenna performs best here, at lowest SWR point, which is at 425.8 MHz. At this frequency is SWR on 1.4. If I move marker to 433-ish MHz, where most things in EU operates, we are on 1.6 SWR, still usable. So antenna is good. Using this device, I was able to build this 2.4 GHz dipole antenna that I tune for exact frequency. It was fun project, and video is here. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.